Prime Minister herself have survived to the end of the second year of their term, despite the predictions of many pundits and Labor's political opponents. The government spent the last sitting week trying to look positive, committing to Gonski school funding reforms, even if leaving the quantum blank, and inching forward with a national disability insurance scheme. The messages swamped by the reheating of a 20-year-old fraud at the Australian Workers' Union and Julia Gillard's role as a lawyer.
I think her position is entirely untenable. If the Prime Minister had any respect for the Parliament, she would resign as Prime Minister today.
She gave false information to the West Australian authorities. It's in breach of the law.
Back it up or shut up.
Yeah. He backed off.
The more we hear from the Prime Minister, the more obvious it is that she has been involved in unethical conduct and possibly unlawful behaviour.
The Leader of the Opposition is now handcuffed to an allegation against me that I committed a crime, and he is handcuffed to the fact that he does not have any evidence of that.
Now, a key witness for the prosecution, bagman and self-confessed fraudster Ralph Blewett.
The same fraud that Bruce Wilson was involved in. And
right.
Julia Gillard.
Mr. Blewett, according to people who know him, has been described as a complete imbecile, an idiot, a stooge, a sexist pig, a liar, and his sister has said he's a crook and rotten to the core. His word against mine, make your mind up.
A key witness for the defence, Ms. Gillard's old boyfriend.
You didn't give Ms. Gillard any money for those reservations?
No.
Renovations?
Not at all, never. Why it continues to get a Guernsey is beyond me. Well, it's not beyond me. I understand there's a group of people that are intent on doing as much damage to the Prime Minister as they possibly can.
Julia Gillard joins us shortly. She ends the year in better shape than she began it, leading Tony Abbott as preferred Prime Minister by 13 points in News poll. And the average of the four major polls shows the 17-point gap between the parties in May has been closed to 3 points. Next year's election is winnable, she told Caucus during the week. And you can have your say on Twitter, hashtag MTP10. All that and more coming up.